Welcome to another episode of The Village Show with me, Chuck the Sound Sangoma. I hope you're well. I hope you're doing good. Thank you very much for all the support that you've been showing us here at Chitangani Productions. We really, really appreciate you. This is episode 32. You know, thank you again for joining me. You know, it's been a long journey. Like always, today I got a very, very nice jam-packed show for you guys. You know, on the video appreciation day today, we got Surf Boys. You know, Surf Boys are pushing that Pitori rap, which is taking South Africa by storm. You know, we look at some music from Surf Boys. You know what I mean? On our topic of the week, you know, as I promised you, I did an episode about AI. So I went and actually found somebody, you know, who knows a little bit more than me. You know, Chaz Dan is going to be speaking a little bit about, you know, AI. Of course, we're going to have a full episode of what we're going to be showing you on the indie state. On the music appreciation, we have Cream Machine. This is an artist from Cape Town who's coming with some Afrikaans drill. Still appreciating that Afrikaans drill, like Matt Levi, who we played last week. You know, if you haven't watched, you can go and actually watch that episode. On our Kasi Superhero, today we're going to be appreciating, you know, a hero man like, you know, Tsietsi Mashinini. You know, Mr. Tsietsi Mashinini has played a very, very, you know, big role in South African education, as he was one of the people who were in the forefront of the 1976 student uprising. And on our trailer watch, we're going to be watching a trailer called Kings of Melbury. You know, this is a, you know, dope comedy that we're going to be watching on our, you know, trailer watch. Again, thank you very much. You know, without further ado, let's get to it. This is still The Village Show with me, Chuck the Sound Sangoma. Hope you're still good. Hope you're nice. Hope you're having a beautiful Monday. As we get into the show, like I promised, today we have a very, very dope song. You know, this is Surf Boys with the song Lipatla. You know, this is a very, very dope song. These guys are doing great things. You know that era of Pitori rap, which is taking over right now. You know, I saw Surf Boys from somebody's status on Instagram, and I followed them and I found this on YouTube, and they've been making some really dope song. Again, just go and make sure that you engage with their music. Without me speaking a lot, here is Surf Boys.
I saw your neck, mara utu on my five, it's just like a fraud. Kamara north, we hele bomara Pakistan, we shimli di skep sel. Tamira kaso, tamira kaso. Elega wizi, gaiti, we mezi mama ufe ya keri, ya keri. Kluwala chain in jaga, say good kira bo wain in jaga. Kluwala chain in jaga, tabe yo bagala kwan in jaga. I saw your neck, mara utu on my five, it's just like a fraud.
Frauda ke fraud on jaga. Erege fire champagne in jaga, kaona lupino la cotton jaga. Maybe li get a keen in jaga, kaona lo kata ma woko kafanya. Svari di lo di achincha braga, just give it time, you know what it's worth. If it's Cuban, I'm rocking it real. Singa membongo, that's not a flex. Get a trouble a chin in jaga, pillow bam tobo tro huisa ga kara. Tsepe loro wan tswara in jaga, tswanera tswara, sanya wo zilis. Tanze ki tsepi le lirik, nage se runga ga mao nompo naga spirit. Le lorumpo na bola ete, troko me la tila tau ma fifi. Go to me let's a little blind. Now say your thanks to my mom, cause on Rudolo Nagabe kind. Mama, these niggas are screaming out sorry. Guess it may emit up on getting Monty the Jive. Now Coco Bella Jaga Duga get back to the right.
But I want to try and talk, I ain't away with a lot, what I will repeat. I you know why San Jaga, Yaga guys will ela say it was sickies. Kalagi talk and Jaga, Selega, Holaya Sa San Jaga. Kuwala chain in jaga, say you got gira wa quave on jaga.
I saw your neck, mara utu on my five, it's just like a fraud. Kamara north, we hele bomara Pakistan, shimli di skep sel. Tamira kaso, tamira kaso.
Elega wizi, gaiti, we mezi mama ufe ya keri, ya keri.
tlatlanyang baisisa dima o e swakana zanga wa ngharisa ke thosa lepiatla la snopo kwa kharia nna ompiese rose banking moning o tsena wa mpofala tight that's some leave bra evolup mo na sai kwa tshela saladika tshela sutete ntshwela sedripe smolo tsholwa matute since fanduga ya ke skepa mazupa forever sekomeja bunsi ya zanga ikuts You better see me, me from Hebrew, Nijaga, Nike, Wagyu, Wolf. Scammers and robbers, man, judge. Ramashu, Nisonya, Galosat.
La, 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 la. Henga no spina, ke meili, wano long pecha, ga kop. I don't smoke tails, baby, to keep off of the bomb. Back of the Uber, egg shit down, to blow me some steam. She tame in a big dog, oh boy, I'm off and on heat. My pillow, I fantasize when I say I'm chasing the dream. Far from meeting the eye, man, I can't wear fake gold chain. Yeah. Da 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 da. Oh shit, that shit's off. Damn.
For dope music right there. With Seth Boyz with the song Le Panta. You check what I mean? You know, very, very dope flows, dope rhymes. I like, you know, their vocal. You know, we're sitting everything, the music video, that's pretty dope. Please make sure that you go engage with their content on YouTube and all of the streaming services. Make sure that you follow them on their social media, Seth Boyz. On our topic of the week this week, like I said, on the previous weeks, I did an episode while I was talking about AI. So I had a chance to actually, you know, have a sit down with somebody who's really clued up when it comes to this new technology that we're seeing, things like blockchain, Web3, and AI. So I'm going to be playing you a clip, you know, a short clip from our interview. If you want to watch the full interview will be available on the Indie States on Thursday on this YouTube page. You know, we're on season 2 right there. So I'm going to play a video from Chess Dan, who's going to be talking about AI. How do we actually approach AI? How do we actually make money from AI? You know, what are these things that AI can bring into our life? What are some of the dangers of actually AI? So again, without me speaking a lot, I'm going to leave this floor to Chess Dan to tell you guys more about AI, Web3, and blockchain.
Before, it was only the people that were testing the technology in little labs and little workshops, right? But this is the first time that we, and ever since, because there were many, many programs before ChatGPT launched, we were using Copy AI. I don't know if you know Copy AI, copy.ai.
I know you.
Way before ChatGPT, we were coming up with, we were doing all of our presentations, all of that with Copy AI. Tell it what we want to write about, and then it gives us something nice, right? Mm. So these AI tools have been around. The biggest opportunity right now, and this is why I think that the creative economy is going to get super amplified. I think that this next 20 years are really going to be for the people that are running individual businesses. Mm. Lean businesses, like personal brand type of businesses. Mm-hmm. Like if I was to stop building what I'm building now and just focus on an NFT incubator program, I just become known for making NFT projects, yeah. Right? And just become really, really, like really good at that. Yeah. And then build my business with AI, blockchain, blah, 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 right? AI is proposing an incredible opportunity for efficiency and output for us creators. ChatGPT can write something that, honestly, I'm not saying that I'm not capable of writing that stuff. Mm. It's just going to take me a few hours.
For sure.
Why not just 4 or 10x my output in a day?
Yes.
By getting AI assistance?
For sure.
You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Instead of me wasting, or I'm not saying wasting, but instead of me spending, 4 hours coming up with all of the outreach emails that I need to do, mm-hmm. Why can't I just get ChatGPT to write everything for me?
Sure.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And when I read the stuff that ChatGPT comes out with, I'm like, I could have written that. Not as fast as it though.
Yeah.
It does it in seconds.
Yeah, for sure.
That thing would have taken me an hour.
Yeah.
Now I've saved, you know, 59 minutes and 45 seconds.
Yeah.
And now I, in brain capacity,
yeah.
And now I can go spend that 59 minutes and 45 seconds elsewhere,
yeah.
You know, and getting more productive. And this is why I'm saying that, like, we need to kind of embrace it because it's not going anywhere, firstly.
Oh, definitely.
Secondly, I think it could be used to 10x your output of work.
Yeah.
in a day, which I think you should be using it for that.
Yeah.
And I think that you should really start looking at how to integrate it into your business to give you a competitive edge.
Sure.
Because, classic example, Microsoft, Bing, you know Bing?
Yeah.
Dude, what is Bing compared to Google? Google search engine. Like, what is Bing compared to Google?
Sometimes I forget Bing. Yeah.
Bruh.
Yeah, sometimes I even forget about Bing.
you see what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
But now Microsoft own OpenAI. So they own ChatGPT. They own that company.
Yeah,
like, now Bing, all of a sudden, is now becoming a competitor to Google.
Mm.
Right? So where they were lacking in innovation, now they've got that one tool that can put them on par or more,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And now, just that example alone proves that every business needs to start implementing or integrating AI into their business to give them a competitive advantage so they can actually survive in our marketplace,
yeah.
Right? And this is an example I used for you. I told you earlier, like in 2023, like if your business is not on social media, do you have a business? In 2033, if your business does not have AI and blockchain integration, do you actually have a competitive advantage?
No.
No. Why? Because what's taking these guys 5 seconds to do, I'm still spending an hour and a half trying to write the same thing. You know? Just use it. Yeah. Integrate it. Stop being scared. Educate yourself, you know? Yeah. And then you'll also start to realize now, especially in this early stage, AIs are a little bit dumb. You know, there's still so much that we have to do in order for it to get the output that an AI has to do.
Yeah.
It's not, so it isn't at the point, which it will get to, where it can completely like just do things for itself, you know. But for now, it's not replacing jobs.
Yeah.
If anything, it should make you faster at your job.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's worry about it replacing jobs in 5 years' time.
For sure.
You know, maybe even two. You never know, right? But output, that's what I think about AI. And that's the only thing I'm using it for now, is to amplify my output. Simple as that. If I can be 10 times more productive in a day,
yeah.
And that's the tool, bro, why wouldn't I want to use that thing?
For sure.
That's just Dan right there with some information. Again, like I said, if you want to watch the full episode, you can wait for it on Thursday on this channel right here. Just Dan is a very, very clued up person. There's going to be more between me and him, and I appreciate him sharing the knowledge and everything that he spoke about there, which is very, very important for us to transition and understand how some of this technology can solve our problems and where do we actually fit in. You know, do we fit in as just consumers and users, and who are the builders? You know, Just Dan is one of the guys that's very, very clued up that I've met. His ideologies and how he thinks about things actually blew my mind, you know. So I really, really wanted to share some of his knowledge and how he looks at things, you know, as an entrepreneur and somebody who's a strategist when it comes to this new technology, things like blockchain, Web3, and AI, as he was talking about there.
Afrikaans rap is in Cape Town especially, we are very attached to the hip-hop movement, where hip-hop is saying, we will not conform. That is what hip-hop is saying. We will not conform, we want to do this our way in class. Who was spinning on the heads before hip-hop? Everyone was doing this car. And hip-hop was saying, no man, I'm gonna spin on my head. Fuck you, what did you see?
Young Shannon J, he the plug boy.
Nacht boy, blij in die skag boy. Ja. Ik skyn in die nacht boy, ik blij in die skag boy. Mijn day koppel kracht, zet ik main switches af boy. Champion sound, while I make it, wacht boy. Wij prijzen de stap, zoals die bass van die sap boy. Ahoy na boy, van jullie maak ik zat boy. Jullie wordt gekrast, zoals die pullen in die tracks boy. Die spirit van die kaap, zij is full as in een zak boy. Vat jullie mannen praat, doen ik kan terwijl ik slaap boy. Ahoy, ahoy, kennis wil mij zacht boy.
boy. Jou kinders vat ek af, boy, and I'm not even that mooi. Sy bounce met die round, pretty brown as sy gat gooi. Koi sun, boy, nou's alles under the sun, koi. Clowns in die town, when your sound laat my lach, boy. Siekheid en announce met de vrouw, ek is klaar, boy. Cream is in fans, sal my nie verlaat, nooit. Here the weekend, on the weekend, I'm still a star, boy.
Yo, nah, ek is op die. High all the time, ek is op die. Die over vibes, ek is op die. My style was a bite, can you stop die? Can you stop your night? I can stop die. High all the time, make a stop die. Die over vibes, I can stop die. My style was a bite, can you stop die? Can you stop your night? You're just up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up your night. You're just up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up your night. You're just fast as you neck, ek die hotste rhyme. Kan ek kaats giet soos Black Jack, sonne pyne. Ja, gie my face, ek cream koppelijne. Met batteries moet zeep, van hip hop is myne. Wait up, hoe kan sy vir my wil beklei, huh? Sy is wek, sy is scrap, ek is uiste. Luister, jylle word gebuig hier so. Mag die kap en mag die straat getuig hier so. Nog een lijn oor jou kop, die kom my bop. Cause I don't wanna wait in wijn om my dop. Gee jou wek rippe, pijn in die kop. I never get credit, want die game is geklok. Die is die, ontlasting wat dreine verstop. Toets my kracht dan, blijd sy geskok. Ek doe nie hakka en skuif my in jou bok. Sy stap up, vang het samstaat en ry om die blok. Jou tyde is op, sy was maar tydelik top. Jou paar seconds of fame het gestop. Sy was maar tydelik hot, maar sy feit soos sy style wat die babe snui in jou kop. Ek is op die, op die, op die, op die, op die, op die, op jou naai. Ek is op die, op die, op die, op die, op die, op die, op jou naai. Ek is op die, high all the time, ek is op die. Die over vibes, ek is op die. My style wil sy bite, kan jy stop die? Kan jy stop jou naai, ek is op die. High all the time, ek is op die. Die over vibes, ek is op die. My style was a bite, can you stop die? Can you stop your night? You're just up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up your night. You're just up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up die, up your night. You're just up die, up die.
As we carry on with the show today, you know, on our Kasi Superhero, we're going to be appreciating, you know, one of the biggest or one of the, you know, boldest person that I've ever known, which is Mr. Tieti Mashinini. Tieti Mashinini is an activist. You know, he's well known for the, you know, 1976 student march. You know, Tieti Mashinini believed in liberating the people, and he believed that education was one of the biggest things that needed to be liberated. You know, for that, Tieti Mashinini went into a quest with other people to actually make it a mission that they make people who were in government at that time understand that it's important for us to revolutionize, you know, the education system. Some of the things that Tieti Mashinini actually said in some of the interviews, I feel like they're still relevant. You know, there's going to be an interview that I'll play for you guys. You know, you listen to that and then you look at where we at. Some of the things are still relevant. We're still fighting the same fight.
People passed, people ran away, and this kid innocently raised his fist in a black power sign and said power to this passing hippo. The hippo stopped there on the spot and they opened fire on this 8-year kid. When I went to the mortuary on the weekend, I saw this kid at the mortuary. She was riddled with bullets beyond recognition. The black student in South Africa is being fed the type of education that will domesticate him to become a better tool for the white man when he joins the working community. School libraries, school books, they've got nothing to do with civics or anything that is affiliated in any manner to politics. What happens is we are fed a lot of fiction stories. I could quote so many authors in fictitious writers that you would be surprised where I get them. Even our libraries are ill-equipped. You don't get much works on, say, democracy, communism, fascism, capitalism, and all that. We only know these things as concepts and something not within our world.
It's more than likely, Tsetse, that you're being described up and down the country at the moment as a communist.
There is no truth in that as far as I'm concerned. It is just that in South Africa, if you're not doing what the government expects you to do, then you are a communist, of course.
As we interviewed Tsietsi Mashinini, the news came in of how successful the students' plan had been.
It makes me very happy, very happy.
What is it actually achieving now?
The idea is, we blacks in South Africa do not have arms. And the only thing we can hit at the system with is just to cripple the economy of the country and make our faint cries reach the ears of the authorities. Because apparently if we demonstrate, they just shoot at us. And if they don't shoot, they detain a whole lot of students. Now we are trying to be as peaceful as possible. Detain the parents at home, and the parents are with us and they are prepared to stay at home as long as the students want them to stay at home. Now, with this, we believe the authorities will feel the pinch, and some way or the other, they'll have to succumb to our demand.
You know, so for that reason, and for giving his life to helping other people, not only just him, and being a hero and being an activist in South Africa, I would like to take my hat off to Mr. Tsietsi Mashinini and say that we as South African youth, we as South African people really appreciate you for everything that you have done, you know, and we'll keep on carrying the struggle forward in making sure that we get to a point where our education is liberated and we are able to see, you know, and able to use the education, and in, it's helping us in educating the right information and giving the people the right information that's needed. So to Mr. Tsietsi Mashinini here at the Village Show and all of the villagers, we take our hat off and appreciate you for everything that you have done for the South African country. Cool. You know, as we near the end of our show, you know, today at the end of the show, you know, on our trailer watch, we have a movie from Netflix, which is, you know, Kings of Melbury. You know, this is a Bollywood kind of like nice movie, you know, with dope acting. It's a comedy, you know, one of those beautiful movies that if you just have your family and you just want to watch a good movie, you can put it on and watch it. Without me speaking a lot, here's the trailer for the movie of the week, which is Kings of Melbury.
Abel. What's this?
I'm dressed to impress.
More like cruising for a bruising ex, eh?
You saw those two ladies with that hair that got me fired.
Which hair? It's raining hairs here tonight.
Damn, man. It's payback time, ladies.
It is called every man.
I want you to help me steal this necklace. Your time is running out.
There must be something we can do.
There might be a way. What if we staged a Bollywood show extravaganza?
While that's happening, we steal the necklace. I say let's do it.
We need your help. You two ruined my party. You better not get distracted, XA. I'm tuning you. You're like a lovesick puppy around her.
How can you even allow this?
I love Ma too. So what do you want to do?
I guess I have no choice but to join you.
Hey, Lani, I got the perfect role for you.
Good evening and welcome to the first ever Bollywood extravaganza.
That's the trailer watch. Again, Kings of Melbury. As you can see, very, very funny movie. You know what I mean? One of those movies that you watch over and over just for the laughs and the gags. You know what I mean? If you're watching up until this point, I got much love from you. I got much love for you. You know, here at Chitangani Productions, we appreciate all your support. We appreciate all your likes. We appreciate all your comments. We appreciate all your follows. We appreciate all your streams and everything that you do to grow this page. We really, really appreciate you. We're hoping that we're educating. As you know, the moral of the show is the Village Show, because it takes a village to raise a kid or to raise a child, you know. And me, Chuck the Sound Sangoma, I really appreciate you guys and have a beautiful week. This is it from us today, or this is it from us this week. Check you out next week. Thank you very much for tuning in. Don't forget to do all of those things, like and subscribing. From me, Chuck the Sound Sangoma, much love. Have a beautiful week. See you next time.